at 10.
I don't know how long the marsh fires are going to burn, but if we continue to get fogged, then we're probably going to get more accidents and stuff.
Tonight, new measures are in place as thousands of tourists and locals prepare to travel what has been a dangerous stretch of interstate heading into New Orleans. Thousands of college football fans heading to the BCS National Championship will drive into the city over the next several days.
And many will travel to the same area where two serious multi-vehicle accidents happened in the past week. WDSU reporter Simney Chuen joins us live with how the city is responding to concerns about I-10 and New Orleans East. Simney?
Norman Scott, behind me, you see the interstate near the Crowder exit, those lights in the median all off. But further east, city officials say they have turned those lights on I-10 between 510 and the Michoud exit. The city says there was added urgency to make the interstate safer because of the extra traffic coming in for the BCS championships and because of those accidents happening just days apart. Drivers say they hope these new signs on Interstate 10 will help prevent two major accidents in the same area, which officials blame on poor visibility due to fog and lingering smoke from the stubborn marsh fire.
We wake up in the morning, you can smell it, and then it's like foggy. It's really hard to see out when you're going into town.
The signs have been placed on both sides of the interstate from the Twin Spans to the Michoud exit, but some doubt whether the signs will really make that big of a difference.
You just need to drive cautiously. I think that's the biggest problem.
But the other problem, according to other drivers, that lingering smoke from the marsh fire that started back in August. The city, along with the State Department of Agriculture, are regularly sending planes into the air to monitor the area and say hot spots are still smoldering, but there are no visible flames. Meanwhile, the city says crews inspected all the lights on I-10 in the east. People who live in the area are surprised, but say the lights are a long time coming after being in the dark for so long.
It's good news, but then it's bad news because it should have been done. It should have, before people came back in town, it should have been done.
Now, drivers say they do blame Mother Nature for some of those dangerous driving conditions, that is, and some of those accidents, but they think that extra police presence could do something about drivers that go too fast or follow too closely. Now, once again, those lights in the median of the interstate between the Michoud exit and 510 are now back on. On your side, live from New Orleans East, Simney Chuen, WDSU News.
All right, Simney, encouraging news. Meantime, a city spokesperson says the fire department conducts daily ground patrols around the marsh fire to make sure there are no flames.